Well, that right there, my friends, is what an American Saturday night sounds like. Pure, undiluted country. Emmylou Harris getting our evening started off the Opry way. Man, here we go. And joining her tonight on stereo left, Vince Gill, and on stereo right is Rodney Crowell. This is gonna be great. Hey guys, I'm Bobby Bones. Welcome to Opry Live right here on Circle Network. You know, we're the new TV home of the Opry and a lot of other cool country music shows as well. You know, maybe this can be your new TV home. Circle Networks in your city, just go to circleplus.com or your cable guide and find out where. Now, if you're on Dish, you'll find the Opry on channel 102. All right, let's go. You know, I said earlier, these three artists are what the perfect Saturday night sounds like. I mean, actually, to me, this is what America sounds like. Each of their voices stirs something in our hearts that goes right down to the ground that we stand on. Their music always seems to resonate with our roots and with who we are. Now, can you tell I'm a fan? I'm getting excited here. It's my privilege to tell you, this is Emmylou Harris, Rodney Crowell, and Vince Gill.
Welcome back, everybody. I can't think of a better place I would want to be with two of my favorite people, Rodney Crowell, Vince Gill. And even more special, we have Eamon McLaughlin back there playing fiddle and mandolin. And I also just want to say happy 89th birthday to Ramblin' Jack Elliott.
Yes, today is birthday.
Yes. Well, here we are, social distancing, but able to make some music. I think, Vince, you're next.
Okay, fair enough.
You're next, whether you want to be or not.
Yeah, glad you guys are here. We've been doing this for a few months now, a bunch of different shows, yeah. And it's been a blast. And, you know, nobody's here, but a lot of people are watching, a lot of people are listening. So still kind of like the Opry always has been. People
well, it's listening. Great that it was fantastic that the Opry didn't, skip a beat. Yeah. They kept on with the tradition. And somehow gives you hope for everything else. So thank you, Grand Ole Opry.
Right on. This is an old song that I wrote with Rodney and Guy Clark, and real special to me. We all been friends. They've been friends for a few years longer than me, but we all met back in 1977.
You're the rookie.
Yeah, I'm the kid. The 63-year-old kid. This is called Oklahoma Borderline. Down in Houston, got holes in both my shoes. Baby's put me on the street. She says I'm through with you. She thinks I'm gonna miss her. Someone tell her that she's wrong. I'm going back to Oklahoma, boys. That's where I belong. I need one good ride. I'll be satisfied. Come come on, Oklahoma, for tonight. If we roll all night, she'll be coming in sight. Come on, Oklahoma, for tonight. I don't need no Texas girl dogging me around. I may be an okay son, but I still been to town. Those Oklahoma City girls always treat you right. Tell mama and them I'm coming home. I'm leaving out tonight. I need one good ride. I'll be satisfied. Come on, Oklahoma, for tonight. If we roll all night, she'll be coming into sight. Come on, Oklahoma, borderline. Now with $2 in my pocket, my thumb stuck in the wind. When I cross Red River, boys, I won't be back again. Give me old back roads and truck stops, 18 wheels of twine. Some good old boy to take me to that Oklahoma line. I need one good ride. Satisfied. Come on, Oklahoma, borderline. If we roll all night, she'll be coming in sight. Come on, Oklahoma, borderline. Lord, we roll all night, well, she's coming in sight. Hello, Oklahoma, borderline.
I hope Mom and them are watching.
Mom and them.
Hey, Rodney. Okay. What do you got? What do you got for us?
I'm gonna sing this song. I made up this song.
You made up a lot of songs. Thank goodness.
Hope I can remember the words. My songs have been socially distancing from me. The hour is early. The whole world is quiet. A beautiful morning is about to ignite. Oh, I'm ready for danger, but I'm ready for fire, and I'm ready for something that'll lift me up higher. Life's been good, I guess. My ragged old heart's been blessed with so much more than meets the eye. I've got a past I won't soon forget. You ain't seen nothing yet. I'm still learning how to fly. It's your dreams that die hard with these habits to break. You can't let down your guard when there's so much at stake. Well, I'm halfway to heaven, halfway to hell, but I might roll a 7, you never can tell. Life's been good, it's true. When I'm feeling just like new, the same old rules need not apply. I've got a past full of sticks and stones, and a good feeling in my bones. I'm still learning how to fly. Thank you. down. I don't wanna get off of this merry-go-round. I wanna be reckless. I wanna be vain. I wanna make love like a runaway train. Life's been good, I've said. I'm 10,000 miles ahead. The day I rest is the day I die. I've got a past like a broken wing. You ain't seen anything. I'm still learning how to fly. I'm still learning how to fly. Thank you, Eamon.
Tonight's Opry performance is brought to you by Bass Pro Shops and Cabela's. Let's get back to nature.
Well, hello, everybody, and thank you for joining us again on a very special night at the Grand Ole Opry here on the live stream. My name is Natalie Stovall, and I am delighted once again to be hosting this live stream while TV and radio are on their commercial breaks. We don't go to commercial breaks on the live stream, so that's why I'm here, because we get to talk and hang out, and you guys actually get to see a little bit of behind the scenes and see the artists talking in between songs, which is a cool part about being on the live stream part. So thank you guys for joining us, and what a special night this is. I've been looking forward to this show from the second that I heard rumors and murmurings that this might happen with Vince Gill, Emmylou Harris, and Rodney Crowell. Y'all, these are three of our greatest storytellers in country music. They're all incredible solo artists. They've all played with and for each other on records and bands. Yeah. They go back to the 70s when they all first met. It's really, really special to see them in this capacity, especially since we're not quite at the point where we can have people in the seats yet. You know, the fact that we all get to feel like we're just in their living room with them. It just happens to be the Grand Ole Opry stage. And of course, that's because of this great network that we have that just started in January of this year called Circle. And you guys, Circle will keep you up to date on everything going on. Be sure and follow us on socials at Circle All Access. You can go to Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. You can pick your favorite. You can go to all three. And also, we have a Circle newsletter, which we call a Circle Up. So if you go to circleplus.com/newsletter, we'll keep you informed on all the great things that are happening. Circle is not only the place for the Grand Ole Opry live every Saturday night, but there's a ton of awesome programming that's also on the network. I have a show called The Southern Weekend, which is really fun because I get to highlight the best of Nashville. I grew up right outside of Nashville, so I love getting to show off this wonderful town. And then there's a bunch of other fun places too, like, well, you can go to Coffee Country Cody every single morning. They're on 5 days a week. But we are so happy to be here. The camera's going to go ahead and start moving back to that stage because there's so much amazing show left tonight. I can't wait for you guys to hear everything that I've been hearing at Soundcheck with Vince Gill, Emmylou Harris, and Rodney Crowell once again here on the Grand Ole Opry.
You know, it's so great to be on the stage. I was remembering that the first time I was on the stage, 1975, my first album had come out, and the single, which was the first song that we did tonight for you people, If I Could Only Win Your Love, and I sang it with Charlie Louvin, who was one of the authors, Charlie and Ira Louvin. But that was a real thrill for me, you know, to be welcomed into the country community, and look at where, here we are. It's so great to be here with my friends, and Rodney and I first met in 1974. That's how far back we go, and almost from the beginning, we said, we got to do an album together one of these days. So about 44 years later, we did an album called Oh Yellow Moon, We were busy. We were out on the road, and we were having too much fun. But anyway, we had a lot of fun making this record of Oh Yell and Moon. So I'm going to do the title track that was written by another friend of the three of us, Hank DeVito, along with Lynn Langham. And just one of my favorite songs, and especially now, I don't know why we're having to stay apart from each other. And this song is really can be about couples, about friends, about your children. It's just about being with the people that you love out under the stars. We are counting the stars out in the night, round an old yellow moon with you right by my side.
To sing an old song of yours, Rodney, that I first learned. I think the first people to ever cut this song of yours were The Seldom Seen, and John Starling, I believe, sang this. And this is one of the very first songs of yours I ever learned to sing, and just thought I'd do it tonight in honor of your birthday coming up in just a few days.
Oh, man.
Just ain't my style. The hard times don't hurt like they ought to. They pass quicker, like when I was a child. And somehow I've learned how to listen for a sound like the sun going down. In the magic my feet on the ground. Oh, it's midsummer days, sit so heavy. Don't they flow like the breeze through your mind? When nothing appears in a hurry, someone's lost time. And somehow I've learned how to listen for a sound like the sun going down. In the magic the morning is bringing, there's a song the life I have found. It keeps my feet on the ground. And somehow I've learned how to listen for a sound like the breeze dying. In the magic the morning is bringing, there's a song for the friend I have found. It keeps my feet on the ground. And somehow I learned how to listen to a sound like the breeze dying down. In the magic the morning is bringing, there's a song for the friend I have found. It keeps my feet on the ground. Love you, old friend.
Oh, man. God, as long as I've known you, you can still make me cry.
It's his job.
Man. Let's take a commercial break, and we can all cry.
Well, I feel the exact same way, Rodney, because Vince was on the show just a couple of weeks ago with Reba, and out of nowhere, he was singing and he made me start crying. Vince just seems to have that effect on everybody, but I love that he just did that song. You know, when you start digging into Emmylou's catalog, it's amazing how many of the songs that she's recorded over the years were written by Rodney Crowell, but you can almost say that about any country artist. He's written so many big hit songs. It's so incredible. And here at the Grand Ole Opry, we are so thankful to our sponsors and our partners that make this show happen. They make sure that this happens every single Saturday night. So even if you can't be here in the room with us, you can be watching from your homes, from your couch, from your phone, from your computer. It's so awesome. So we want to say a big thank you and shout out to Cabela's and Bass Pro Shops. They are always encouraging us to get outdoors and post photos of all the fun things that you're doing with your families, all the fun things you're doing outside. Use the hashtag #BackToNature with the number 2 and then tag either Bass Pro or Cabela's. The Bass Pro's founder, Johnny Morris, he's so passionate about encouraging us all to get outside, and it's really important for all of us. And also another thing I want to mention is the Opry posters. You guys have heard me gush about these. I'm going to get the one from tonight. These posters, I love, love the Opry posters. So if you go to opry.com and click on the shop, you can get yourself one of these beautiful collector's items. I have quite a collection at home on my own wall. And the best part is, if you purchase one of these posters to remember this amazing evening that we're all spending together, you're not just helping yourself and sprucing up your home, but you're helping the Opry Trust. And the Opry Trust was established in 1965 and helps so many members of the country music community that are in need, and people can nominate individuals that have gone through a hard time. It extends not just to artists and performers and songwriters, but even people from behind the scenes. And so, you guys, these Opry posters, I can attest to it. They are amazing. They look great on your wall. You can frame them, and you don't even have to frame them. None of mine are framed. And I love them so much. But we have a lot more show coming up right now. But right now, I'm going to send it back over to Bobby Bones.
Welcome back to Opry Live. Hey, guys, I'm Bobby Bones. All right, exercise here. Take a deep breath. Pretty cool, pretty refreshing, right? Well, actually, that's probably air conditioning, unless you're one of the Australian viewers watching where it's winter right now. But we love air conditioning, no doubt about it. But it's not the same as being outside, right? Which is why our friends at Bass Pro Shops and Cabela's are correctly encouraging everyone to responsibly get outdoors. So go do it. And when you do, post a photo of how you're getting outdoors using the hashtag #BackToNature. Give us all a chance to see your beautiful outdoor smile. Well, this right here, this is my indoor smile. And it popped up about 30 minutes ago when these guys first started to play. I'm betting you got one on too. Here once again, Emmylou Harris, Rodney Crowell, and Vince Gill.
We are back. I think, Rodney, you have a story about this song that Vince just did, right?
Well, first of all, I'm glad we had a commercial break so I could collect myself after Vince broke all of our hearts with that one. I met Vince. Emmylou and I were going down to the Troubadour one night. Byron Berline was playing. And I think we were sitting in with Guy Clark, Byron Berline.
We opened for Guy.
So we walked in, you and I and Guy, and up on the stage is this tall, handsome dude, you know, and he's singing my song, another song. It just broke my heart, you know, and it's like, man, who is this guy? So he comes backstage afterwards, and I said, man, who are you? And what do you mean
to be determined?
My song so much better than I can? It still goes on. But, you know, as long as we're taking a trip down memory lane, our old friendship and how this all got started, for me, I'd made a demo tape here in Nashville, and somehow it floated off. An old bass player named Skip Beckwith took my tape up to Toronto, where Emmylou
was... Across the border.
Yeah, Emmylou was getting together with Brian Ahern to make her first album. And... Emmy tells the story that they listened to stacks and stacks and stacks and stacks of songs and didn't hear anything she liked until she got to this one.
Absolutely.
And it opened up your first album, Emmylou's first album, Pieces of the Sky. And then pretty soon my phone started ringing because people wanted to know if I had any more songs. So.
And he did.
So, I got a career out of this thanks to you, Emmylou. Mm-hmm. It rhymes. See, it all rhymes.
All
Let's
right.
just do that song. We were going to do
all
another
right.
one, but you got to follow where the road leads you. Baby brought me in out of the highway. Put my right good liquor down the sink. Straightened out my crooked ways of thinking. Made it purely pleasure when I drink. And it's all right now. I just hit my stride right off the bat. I'm drunk on divine wine. Baby's up and running in the morning. Says she's got a million things to do, yeah. While I'm gone, she say you go and get your guitar. Write some pretty song about me and you. And it's all right now. I just hit my stride right off the bat. Well, I'm drunk on the bed. Baby says she'd really love a party. Get some friends together, feeling fine, yeah. Any friend of mine is worth a habit. A belly full of baby's bluebird wine. And it's all right now. I just hit my stride.
That's good for spontaneity right there. Oh, I'm next. Okay.
Pressure. No pressure.
Well, as he said, they wanted to know if he had more. That's exactly what happened when I heard Bluebird Wine. I started trying to locate him. He was, you know, somewhere between Austin and Nashville, and find out if he had any more songs, and boy, did he. And over the years, I've recorded quite a few of Rodney's songs. Now this one, he said at least once that Susanna Clark and I inspired this song, and I hope we did. I'm not really a cowgirl, but
indeed
I play one. I play one on, not even on TV. I played one when I was six, I think.
I stole the title, as you know, from Tom Robbins' book.
Right, Tom Robbins' book, which we love Tom Robbins' book, but that was one of the most god-awful movies ever made. But it was a great book.
Great book. And it is a composite of you and Susanna Clark.
All right, here we go then. This is for Susanna. She's a rounder, I can tell you that. She can't sing them all, not too. She raised hell about the sleep she lost. But even cowgirls. Especially cowgirls, they're the gypsy kind. Need the reins laid on them loose. She lived to see the world turn upside down. Itching rides out of the blue. Even the cowgirls get the blues. Sometimes bound and don't know. This feeling like she's too far gone. The only way she's ever been.
Mm-hmm.
and stares you down. There must be safer ways to pay your dues. Oh, and even cowgirls get the blues. Even cowgirls get the blues. Sometimes bound to don't know what to do. Sometimes get this feeling like she's too far gone. The only way she's ever been. Even cowgirls. Okay, I think we have to go.
Was so much fun. It was so awesome too when they first got here for sound check and they were just kind of talking about the songs that they were going to do. I was really hoping they were going to do that song. And Emmy looked at Vince and she goes, okay, you're going to be Dolly. And then she looked at Rodney and said, you be Linda, so that they knew what parts to sing, because she originally did that song on the Blue Kentucky Girl album. But of course it was on the trio record too. But I love that. Vince is Dolly and Rodney is Linda. And we want to say a big shout out again to Dish Network, another one of our partners and sponsors here at the Grand Ole Opry that make this show happen every week. If you are a Dish subscriber, go to channel 102. You already got us. You can see the Grand Ole Opry every single Saturday night. And you can also find out more information on dish.com/Opry Live. Another thing that you guys have heard me talking about are these quizzes that we have up on the Circle website. So it's on circleplus.com. The last few weeks I've been talking about the Opry Star quiz, because you can take a quiz to find out what Opry Star you're most like. I had gotten Allison Krause. I had my bandmates in Runaway June take that quiz. And Jen Wayne got Terry Clark and Naomi got Trisha Yearwood. And I was thinking, what about a trio made up of Allison Krause, Terry Clark, and Trisha Yearwood? That's amazing. And, you know, I mean, if we're talking about trios, Dolly and Linda and Emmylou, it's pretty amazing. But the thing is, they have another quiz. They have another really fun quiz that's all about one of my favorite all-time artists, Garth Brooks. So you can go to circleplus.com/Garth song, and you can take a quiz to find out what Garth Brooks song you are most like. What Garth Brooks song is your life the most like? I got an answer, Prayers, which I love and I think is very appropriate. I think that song is probably appropriate for most folks, because we all think we know what we want out of life, and then sometimes God has other plans. But I want to get to some of these other shout outs. I want to send some shout outs to you guys. I know the camera's going to be moving here in just a second to get back to stage, but you guys, Gabrielle Perry May says, oh God, how happy I am watching this show. Greetings from Merida, Mexico. How amazing. All right, we get to get back to this incredible show here at the Grand Ole Opry.
Back.
Thanks. We have a pretty good time. We haven't done anything we planned on so far. So I think I'm going to keep the streak going.
Yeah. Okay.
We talked earlier about how when we all met and all of that, and this is another song of Rodney's. I hadn't planned on singing. I thought he might sing it, but it's the song that bonded a friendship that's lasted almost 44 years. So sing whatever part you want, brother.
Okay.
just like the sun over the mountaintop. You know I'll always come again. Spend my morning time like sunlight dancing on your skin. Go ahead, buddy.
I've never gone so wrong as for telling lies. You've seen is what I've been. There is nothing I could hide from you. Oh, you see me better.
There are
till I can gain control again.
Again. That was so sweet. What a nice moment for me, because it just connects these two people to me. So it was so dear to me.
Yeah. We got a love fest going.
We are. We just love each other so much. And it's so nice to actually, we do miss the audience, folks. We miss you out there. We want you back. But the reason we're all still here is because of all the many of you who have come to see our shows over the years, no matter what. And we thank you, because this is just about the best job in the world, and it's brought just the best people into my life. And I mean that with Rodney and Vince. So thanks to all of you who are not out there, but who I know you are out there in the universe, for making all these good things possible for the three of us.
Let's get another song from Elrod.
Oh, yeah.
Feel like that okay?
Yeah.
Sound good?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. It'd be another ballad in D, but...
No problem.
No problem.
We got to do this.
We already won them over.
As Emery Gordy would say, it's your career.
It is our career. We're fixing to take it right to the limit right here. So we got a good friend that we wrote this song with. This was on our... It took us 44 years to make our first duet album, but, you know, it was about 9 months later we made another one.
Yeah.
We got the hang of it.
Yeah.
And we wrote this song with Corey Chisel, who's up in Appleton, Wisconsin. And we want to send this out to he and his beautiful bride, Adriel, who they're a duet team that, you know, Emmy, this is an opportunity. We need to lean on them right now and say, you guys need to do a duet of this song yourselves.
Right.
Corey and Adriel, this goes out to you.
Just because we're scared doesn't mean we're wrong. The world won't end today if both of us move on. But didn't we have a time? You can't take that away. We had a change of mind, and I think it's safe to say that I've been holding on to you, and you've been holding on. Cause neither of us wants to be the first to say goodbye. And so it goes, we must admit how we both thought that this was it. Though we couldn't make the pieces in, you can't say we didn't try. So it goes, we've grown apart, guess you could say we lost the heart. And even though we came up short, you can't say we didn't try.
Thanks, Corey.
Tonight's Opry performance is in association with Shriners Hospitals for Children.
Whew, well, as far as I'm concerned, they can sing ballads in D for all of eternity. And Eamon McLaughlin back there on the fiddle can play for all of eternity, because that was so sad and so beautiful. And these three artists are just amazing. I can't believe we're already at the end, but thank you guys once again for joining us here on the live stream. I'm Natalie Stovall, here hosting you guys while TV and radio are off doing the commercial thing. And I want to make sure that I remind you guys that our sponsors at Bass Pro Shops want us to get outdoors, and they want us and tag your photos of doing fun things with your family outside with the hashtag #BackToNature, and tag either Bass Pro or Cabela's so that we can see all the fun that you're up to. And I also want to say that I want to give a big shout out to Eddie Stubbs, speaking of the WSM broadcast on 6:50 a.m. Eddie retired. He did his last show this last Wednesday, and he has been on WSM for 25 years. So we just want to say a big congratulations to you, and thank you for all of these years of just being so amazing. I also want to make sure I mention that the Opry and the Ryman tours are back up and running. So you guys, you can come here to the Opry House and you can take one of the tours. You can see the backstage. You can see what we're doing out here out front. It's such a sacred and beautiful way to experience the Grand Ole Opry. And the same goes for the Ryman Auditorium, the Mother Church of Country Music. It is such an incredible tour. So be sure and go to opry.com, and you can also go to ryman.com. Those are easy. Go to opry.com, ryman.com if you want to take an Opry or Ryman tour. And y'all, next week is going to be so much fun. We're all going to be in bluegrass heaven. We've got Old Crow Medicine Show, we've got Molly Tuttle, Billy Strings, and Dom Flemons. It's going to be such an incredible night. And also, oh, hey, there's a note on here to not forget to catch my show, The Southern Weekend, my show that airs on Circle on Thursday nights at 7 p.m. Central and 8 p.m. Eastern. We have so much fun with that show, but we've got a little bit left here, but thank you guys for having us again. This has been so lovely. I'm going to give it back to Bobby Bones, the best.
Welcome back to Opry Live. Well, got to be honest, this has been amazing. Emmylou, Rodney, Vince, on the same stage and for a whole hour. Woo-wee. You're only going to get that here, folks. I promise you that. Okay, the question is, how do we end this perfect Saturday night the Opry way? I think we'll just leave it in the hands of the experts. And as we head out the door, one more time, here's Emmylou, Rodney, and Vince. Good night, everybody.
Okay, well, we're going to wrap things up, but I just got to give a big old shout out to Eamon back there, our virtuoso on the fiddle and mandolin. Oh.
Thank you very much.
And we got a finale. We kind of came up with that on the fly, too.
Huge finish.
Huge finish. But no dancers or anything like that. The cloggers couldn't make it. But this is another song of Rodney's. And, you know, I was so lucky because I kind of got in on the front end there of Rodney. No, not very many people knew about Rodney, and I had him all to myself. And he would play me every song. When he first wrote it, we were living down there in Hermosa Beach, down there, and he had a song, a dog named Banjo.
He did have a dog named
Banjo. And he kept having to spring him from the pound. That's what Ain't Living Long Like This was written about, folks.
Well, that
it's
was
a little secret.
47 unpaid leash law violations got me thrown in jail.
Anyway, Rodney wrote. I heard this. I think I was the first person to hear this song. You want to say anything else about it, Mr. Crowell?
Yeah, you know, I'll just say a little bit. When I was growing up in Houston, you know, about age 14 or 15, when somebody was old enough to drive, we would head to Louisiana because, you know, they'd sell beer to anybody there. But we would always go, let's go to Louisiana. We're going to meet some girls. Yeah. So we would go, and we would get over there, and we might get some beer, and then we'd just stand around. We didn't meet any girls. Finally, somebody said, well, fool,
they were all going to Houston. Yes, typically. So I wrote this song about leaving Louisiana in the broad daylight.
Mary took to running with a traveling man. Left her mama crying with a head in her hands. Such a sad case. So broken home. Say, mama, gotta go, gotta get out of here. Gotta get out of town, not hanging around. Gotta roll on between the ditches. Just an ordinary story about the way things go round and around. Nobody knows, but the highway goes on forever. That old highway goes on forever. But she never would have done it if she hadn't gotten drunk, hadn't started running with a troubled man, if she hadn't started taking those crazy chances. Traveling kind, everywhere they're going, such a very short time. He'll be long gone before you know it. He'll be long gone before you know it. She said, I never ever known it when it felt so good. Never ever knew it when I knew I could. Never ever done it when it looked so right. Leaving Louisiana in the broad daylight.
Welcome to Circle, a new home for